Sairam sir, and a very warm welcome to Prasanthi Nilayam once again.
Thank you.
So you gave a rousing speech in the Purnachandra Auditorium to inaugurate this special conference on human values and the legal world. In this context, I'd first of all like to ask you, what is the significance of this huge diaspora of people from the legal world who have descended into Prasanthi Nilayam, representing the bar, the bench, and the legal academia, and they're discussing human values? In your considered opinion, what is the significance of an event like this?
I had told today, human values is the embodiment of our organic constitution. We are a diversified and plural society. The intention of the Constitution is to include everyone within its ambit and sweep. And that is why you will find the fundamental concept of human values is an emerging force in every fundamental right. And that is why the lawyers and the judges, while fighting for human rights, also emphasize on human values. There is a distinction between the human values and human rights in a very nuanced way. When someone fights for his own rights, maybe his human right, a thought may come, it's an individualistic approach. But when you really drive home the point and accentuate on that, the individual rises to a collective level, and then it becomes a very, very elevated human value, a human value orientation, and a constitutional principle that touches everyone beyond caste, creed, race, gender, or any kind of categorization. That's the subtle distinction I had mentioned today.
Very profound, sir. And what you just said, it resonates what Bhagwan Baba has also said, because his philosophy is entirely all-inclusive. There is only one race, the race of humanity, and there is only one religion, the religion of love. And you're saying it encompasses all of us. Now, in this context, what we see in society doesn't reflect the lofty values that are cherished in our constitution. So in light of the reality, the ground reality, and in light of the ideal situation that the constitution presents, how do you see today's conference being a catalyst of change?
The theme of the constitution, as I perceive, and the topic today, as has been christened, really are in tune and harmony. The presence of the legal world today conveys that you must abide by the constitution. And our constitution sometimes is called, with immense force, a compassionate constitution. And what I mean by compassionate constitution, it intends to teach that you must live together, live in harmony, live with the idea of coexistence. Harmony, living together, living with coexistence ultimately has to be founded up on the ground called fraternity. That is why we have the conception of constitutional fraternity, and this fraternity is based on love for humanity. Today, ma'am, you must have noted, I have said divinity is humanity. When I said that, I really meant when you elevate yourself as a human being, you achieve divinity. And divinity as a concept, as an idea, is achievable if you really grow better and better as a human being. And you really become a good human being. an elevated human being if you love humanity. One must always remember, whatever is human, you are connected with it. You are never an alien to the human cause. You are a part of it.
So you speak of such high values which are enshrined in our constitution as well as in the culture of Bharat. And yet, in your capacity as the Chief Justice of India, I'm sure you come across a lot of violation of these values. Are you optimistic about the future?
I have always told on many occasions that I am an incurable optimist.
That's nice to know.
I always mean we have a constitution, and the constitution has a culture. The constitutional culture takes into consideration the cultures of this country, all included. And therefore, there are some kind of aberrations sometimes, but that should not be treated creating any kind of dent or impediment in our constitutional values. Constitution and the institution shall always stand supreme, and they have the power and the capacity to withstand and guide by elaborating the constitutional values, ingraining the attitude in the people that you better follow the constitution. And most of the times I have also told people, follow one religion, that is the religion of the constitution. Follow one singular attitude, the attitude that is accepted under the constitution. Live by the constitution and there shall be no problem. Aberrations have to be there as long as the humanity is there. You must appreciate whenever there has been any kind of civilization, there has been some aberrations, but that doesn't decrease the value or the value of the asset of that culture or the civilization.
Very nicely said, sir. Sir, as you know, I was telling you, the Sri Sathya Sai diaspora around the world is several million strong. And I think all those devotees are clued to Radio Sai right now, because it's a great honor for us to have the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of India visit our valley. So for the interest of all our listeners, I'd like to ask you, this is not your first time visiting, as I've just learned from you, Prasanthi Nilayam. You've been here not as the Chief Justice of India, but in your personal capacity when you were a lawyer. What do you recall of your interactions with Baba?
You see, long back, I had the privilege of meeting Baba personally.
In Prasanthi?
In the room where he used to live.
I see.
That privilege I had because I had come with my father and some others, along with Justice Iradi, who was very much connected with Sathya Sai Baba. I was very young, and he only told me, try hard, whatever you are doing, you will do well. I thereafter thought, no more questions should be asked. Once a man like him, or a saint like him, says this, that should be treated as a command. You should not have mundane predictions from saints. Saints speak and you have to listen. That's your obligation. And that's your facet of surrender. And you never get any benefit without the act of surrender.
Beautiful. Wow, and his words are prophetic. So you kept doing what he said, and look at where we are today. Congratulations that you are able to visit this divine holy abode in your capacity as the CJI. It's a very huge deal, I'm sure.
Thank you, ma'am, for your family
and yourself. And so what are the outcomes you expect out of the deliberations over the next 24 hours?
As I saw the audience and the type of audience, they're very receptive. They have come because of their commitment. They have not come here for picnic. They believe in the cause and they believe in the world of love. And when they come to know that the world of love and the idea of love that has been preached by late Baba, that's an insegregable, an inseparable nexus with our constitutional values, they would also feel, oh, Baba also spoke about the constitutional values in a different way. This will be ingrained when the legal world speaks to them in the language of the constitution with the morality and the path Baba guided them.
Very well said, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Great delight to have you talk to us on Radio Sai.
Thank you.
Sai Ram, sir.
Bye.